Please be seated. Inga mana, inga reo, inga hoi fa. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Pro-Chancellor, special guests, graduands, whānau and supporters. As Chancellor of the University of Auckland, I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of council members and staff of the university. This is a meeting of the Council of the University of Auckland at which the Pro-Chancellor and I will award diplomas and confer degrees in the Faculty of Arts and the Faculty of Education and Social Work. Graduation is a time for celebrating success. Today, you will experience the pomp and tradition of this ancient ceremony and the recognition befitting your success on your well-deserved day of celebration. Like your family and friends gathered here, we are very proud of all your achievements and look forward to your lifelong involvement as members of the University of Auckland faculty. Of course, graduation represents much more than just a day of celebration. Your qualification from this university will have a lifetime impact on you, your family, and the community at large. We know that, compared to those whose formal education ends in high school, graduates have lower unemployment rates, higher salaries, better career prospects, and better health outcomes. Universities New Zealand has estimated but the lifetime benefits of earning a degree are valued at between $1 million and $4 million. Your university experience and the qualification gained at university will thus add real value to your lives and the lives of those around you. The fact that our university can add value in these ways reflects the abilities and achievements of our staff and students. In the Faculty of Arts, we've seen several noticeable achievements in the last year. Distinguished Professor Dame Anne Salmond was elected to the position of Vice President, Humanities and Social Sciences, of the Royal Society of New Zealand Council. Professor Mark Mullins was awarded a commendation from Japan's Ministry of Foreign Affairs for his promotion of Japanese research in New Zealand and his contribution to the promotion of friendship between the two countries. Associate Professor Tracy McIntosh was awarded a Tertiary Teaching Excellence Award by the New Zealand Government for sustained excellence in tertiary teaching with a focus on kaupapa Māori. And Dr. Selina Tusitara Marsh was commissioned to write and perform a poem at the Commonwealth Day observance in Westminster Abbey, attended by the Queen. Similarly, in the Faculty of Education and Social Work, Dr. Ray Sulata and Dawn Lawrence were recipients of the 2015 New Zealand Association for Research and Education Awards for Excellence in Educational Research. Associate Professor Bev France and Dr. Kerry Lee won Technology Education Research Awards for their contribution to technology education, research and teaching. Professor Stephen May was elected a fellow of the prestigious American Educational Research Association, and Associate Professor Martin East won a National Tertiary Teaching Excellence Award. We can rightfully be proud of these achievements. In my view, to ensure that we can continue to achieve successes like these, and to enhance our contribution to future generations of graduates and to our nation, the university must do three things. First, we need to attract students of high academic potential and give them an outstanding academic and extracurricular experience. In this respect, we're doing very well. The proportion of domestic students entering the university with a high grade point average is growing each year, and we produce outstanding graduates just like you. Second, we need to attract, develop and retain outstanding staff. This we are doing, as illustrated by the achievements I've just read to you. Many of our staff are world leaders in their fields, and you will have been privileged to learn from and work with them. It's no coincidence that, in the QS World Rankings of University Subjects, the University of Auckland came top in 35 of the 40 ranked subjects, and we don't even teach in two of them. And third, we need to create the kind of academic environment and facilities that support and encourage excellence. To this end, the university has been investing heavily in its campus renewal program to ensure that we provide facilities of genuine international quality. Many of you will graduate today with a first qualification, and you will be rightly proud of this achievement. However, I also want you to reflect on the ongoing learning opportunities and the wide range of postgraduate options available to you at this university. You must never rest on your laurels in a challenging and ever-changing world, but rather be prepared to embrace change and new technology and make the most of the opportunities presented to you. Although it may seem a daunting prospect right now, further study and learning is inevitable for all of us as the world changes around us at an ever-accelerating pace. So whatever path you follow, I urge you, as the alumni of New Zealand's leading university, to never forget your alma mater, your university. We rely on our graduates for support, moral, political, and financial. However, today is your day, with the focus firmly on your achievement. At this ceremony, we honour your success, along with the support of your family, whānau, and others who have sustained you through your studies. I congratulate you and trust that you will long cherish the memories of your graduation today. Our speaker tonight is Professor Peter O'Connor from the University's Faculty of Education and Social Work. Peter is in demand all over the world for his work on using applied theatre in marginalised and vulnerable communities. He has spent 30 years teaching and researching ways in which drama can be used at every level of formal education, in prisons, psychiatric wards, retirement village, and in trauma zones. Peter has recently come back from running a two-week workshop in Jordan and is returning to the Middle East at the end of the year to work hands-on with classroom teachers in West Bank schools and in Bethlehem and the Golan Heights. He describes his teaching as seeking beauty, chasing serendipity, and uncovering the poetic. Peter talks about a pedagogy of surprise that embraces teaching as an improvised art form that celebrates uncertainty and risk. Teaching in and through surprise is a genuine response to the 21st century, he says. Not teaching to prepare for it, but teaching that is part and parcel of it. Peter, we welcome you and look forward to hearing your address tonight.
Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, members of Council, members of the University, graduands, families, colleagues and friends, ngā mihi nui a koutou. I love Graduation Day, seeing the city alive with the pomp and ceremony of tradition, enlivened by the joy of family celebration, a day that marks achievement, possibility, hope and beginnings. Today is a transition between what has been achieved and what is yet to come. I know what it is like to sit and wait for your name to be called out and plan how to walk across the stage without tripping over. Don't worry, it doesn't happen that often. I also know what it's like, though, to watch both as a husband and a father, with deep, deep pride as I've watched my wife and my daughter walk across the stage. Usually, though, I sit as a very proud staff member watching my students be awarded their degrees. I was taught a number of years ago by a colleague to ration out the number of claps per student, because if you clap wildly for 2 hours, you can feel like your hands are about to fall off. So as a personal tip, born out of many years of experience at graduation ceremonies, a few claps each for each graduand and save some real energy for when your own family member walks across the stage. I know from these experiences that individual success marked here today in the awarding of degrees and diplomas is built, as it always is, on the strength of the collective. Our ceremony today brings together graduands from different disciplines, including social work, education, and across the arts. A narrow reading of the role of higher education is that it prepares people for work. Luckily, you are wonderfully prepared for work in the 21st century because of the kind of study you have been involved in. In The Guardian recently, in an article titled "Humans are going to have the edge over robots, where work demands creativity," Tim Dunlop explores the importance of creativity in an age of post-industrialization. He argues wealth is being created not by making and selling physical things, but in areas of knowledge and information transfer. These areas simply do not need as many workers as traditional employers. Where Kodak used to employ 140,000 people and was valued at $28 billion and is now bankrupt thanks to digitization, Instagram was sold to Facebook in 2012 for $1 billion when it employed only 12 people. Facebook itself is the sixth largest company in the US, but it employs a mere 12,000 people full-time. Compare that to, say, General Motors, which during the 1980s employed 349,000 workers in the US alone. In a recent report on the future of work, McKinsey and Company concluded that of the 2,000 work activities they examined, 45% could be automated using already demonstrated technology, not in 10 or 20 years' time, but now. The good news is that humans, for a while yet, are going to have the edge over machines in areas where work demands creativity, empathy, and in areas of artistic expression and practice. It means that STEM skills, science, technology, engineering, and maths, will still be good things to have. However, in a development seldom seen or realised by politicians, who tend to dismiss the arts as soft and impractical, it means that higher education in arts-related subjects, including ethics, critical thinking, and understanding social relationships, are likely to become increasingly valued and in demand. An ability to deal with ambiguity, complexity, and diversity will be desirable. And as CEO Steve Yee of advertising platform Media Alpha said, in the dynamic environment of the technology sector, there is not typically one right answer when you make decisions. There are just different shades of how correct you might be. So parents, relax, those who wondered about the degree your children were taking. They made the right choice. But of course, higher education is not just about training for work. If creativity, criticality, and empathy are important attributes for work, they are the vital skills for surviving and flourishing in the 21st century. In a world that is increasingly confused and confusing, that struggles with vast and irreversible challenges and changes, and education in the arts, in the social sciences, is the very best thing you could have done to be part of the solution to the chaos and complexities this world faces. Your study will have taught you that we only succeed fully as individuals when we succeed as communities. You will understand democracy demands your participation and engagement with the world. Seize it. Simplistic answers from politicians and media celebrities in a post-fact world need to be challenged by informed opinion. Yours, as educated people. Claim your knowledge, your expertise. Never be afraid to speak against ignorance and fear that reveals itself when it is used to divide people against each other. Education is meaningful only when it is imbued with sociological imagination. Imagination that requires us to not only know the world as it is, but to imagine it as it might be. That is the hope and wonder of days like today. Graduands, take the knowledge and skills you have gained to make not just your own lives better, but all our lives better. That is what we celebrate today. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa.
Peter, thank you for a most insightful and challenging address. We can see why you're in demand wherever you go. Please join with me in thanking Peter once again. This is a meeting of Council and Convocation of the University, at which the Pro-Chancellor, Scott St. John, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of the ceremony.
By the authority vested in me, by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Scott St. John, Pro-Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who within the Faculty of Arts have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Arts, Professor Robert Greenberg, to present graduands in the faculty.
Dean, I have the honor of presenting to you students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Arts. Diploma in Languages. David Paul Lyle Gregg. Graduate Diploma in Arts. Kenya Verma. Heijin Yoon. To the degree of Bachelor of Arts. Stephanie Ellen Adams. Chika Deborah Adenike Adeoshun. Pelu Jeremy Afaese. Kashidi Al Hakim bin Ahmad Ali. Janika Ologa Amadea. Teresa Marie Armstrong. Tofa Rosie Badawi. Idris Balizi. Ahmed Bashir. Rico Ray Bautista. Tui Heikura Kingston Beach. Nathan Bjorn Bell. Natasha Kumari Bangal. Dean Jared Billman. Arapera Pia Blank Penetito. Alex Ian Orr Boyd. Amy Macquarie Brown. Matthew Logan Brunton. Nicholas Reginald Edward Bunyan. Steffi Jade Burrows. Anushka Alexia Carney. Ricardo Luz Cesar. Claire Chang. Qinghua Chen. Chenhui Cheng. Kwok Ho Horace Cheng. Insoon Cho. Rachel Janice Choi. Rebecca Choi. Cassandra Dean Ariella Kokurulo Whitford. Sabrina Zelda Shirley Mary Compton. Lucia Bridie Kahn. Guy Patrick Cowan. Haiti Roselle Crispin. Samuel John Cusson. Lindsay Monica Daniels. Courtney Brooke Davidson. Hannah Louise Davies. Katie Elizabeth Deller. Duan Si Nguyen. Abby Jane Donaldson. Miroslav Georgievic. Bree Marissa Downey. Sarah Elizabeth Jane Drinkwater. Sujata Dubé. Catherine Teresa Ann Dunbar. Morgan Hannah Jaferik. Leone Fa'atalele. Isaac Sopi Laolive Fanueli. Yao Feng. Blaine Robert Fennick. Carmen Ott Middleton Thepulea'i. Alexandra Grace Ferguson. Alexandria Luisa Fernando. Albert Fakamono Ki Hawkesbury Fihaki. Jessica Rachel Walker Finucane. Michael Trent Fong Ross. William David Francis Dittmar. Holly Serena Frankham. Nicole Franklin. Poppy Eliza Lowe Fraser. Tanya Zoe Fu. Joseph Roy Fursden. Kane Joshua Galbraith. Annie Jean Gibson. Megan Ray Gibson. Christopher Goodall. Lucia Florence Grant Good. Kate Alice Gordon. Amy Louise Grant. Victoria Carol Gray. Brianna Jo Green. Junsheng Guo. Daniel Rewi Paul Haynes. Adele Jane Hall. Isabel Susanna Juliette Hallwright. Glenn Hawes. Claire Louise Henderson. Samuel Brian Hewitt. Bonnie Rose Houston. Louis Thomas Hoy. Daniel Sean Hunter. Jaspreet Kaur Dador. Tabassum Jahan. Hyun Woo Jo. Hajira Johnston. Christopher Nicholas Jones. Ah Young Ju. Matarena Cabuea. Mahina Victoria Castler. Zareen Roshan Ara Khan. Andrew John Kidd. Mi Jin Kim. Min Jong Kim. Bridget Cherie Kimura. Anong Klinyu. Leah Catherine Kostelik. Camille Minaka Kamachi Krishna. Grace Parno Lata Kumar. Pro-Chancellor, I now call upon the Associate Dean of the Faculty of Arts, Professor Christine Arkenstall, to present further graduates.
To the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Kwok Hae Sen. Ju Ri Kwan. Mary Helala Lada. Vijay William Loud. Andiraneta Papau Lavasi. L. Harrington Lavea. Rebecca Louise Lawrence. Arum Lee. Madeline Chara Lee. Samantha Olwyn Karen Lee. Stephen Poyu Lee. Amanda Bowie Lee. Wen Ru Lee. Usha Lee. Cindy Sheeny Lin. Paige Rotong Lin. Fanyin Leo. Rebecca Ann Lloyd Hageman. Man Ting Lo. Nicholas Selwyn Wilson Logan. Ray Anthony Martin Lopez. Rosie Isabella Luke. Ellis Ueno Lynch. Janing Ma. Ma Kwok Yen Miki. Aiden Francis McNaughton. Mere Tutasi Mailo. Anita Josephine Te Poete Marama Maletino. Mandy. Saya John Manasse. Christina Janelle Manes. Alit Nisha Marsh. Cola de Olola Tubo Massima. Wakana Ellis Matheson and a diploma in languages. Corena Mabel Matika. Kate Rose McCulloch. Carl Robert James McGurk. Ellie David McCown. Craig McWilliams. Fernando Mendes de Bajos. Sumakan Michak. Naomi Ellison Moore. James Arthur Morell. Emily Jo Morrison. Catherine Anita Moonga. Jaitishna Mudaliar. Maria Mujtaba. Dahlia Grace Murphy. Gloria Namanu. Faye Nanai. Monica Vikashni Nan. Brian Narcisse. Mina Sosan Nasiri. Jesse Joan Kiri Nathan. Ferete Kalahata Ne Emia. Janelle Dana Isabel Nicholas Wright. Nir Ijal. Samuel Stephen Nola. Hannah Ruth Osborne. Camille Rose Freewin Owen. Aaron Christopher Lance Parfitt. Jonathan Paul Parker. Danielle Sarah Pashatum. Binal Patel. George Matthew Michael Pierce. Luke Benjamin Penrose. Angelica De La Rosa Peralta. Emma Jane Pickles. Simone Frances Boyinger Hill. Leah Genria Daisy Sarah Potusa. Atarao Nadia Pofare Ellis. Shivani Kushbu Prakash. James Watson Song Wong Prentice. Loloma Polete. James Abraham Reveal. Rose Ritchie. Bethany Alana Robb. Jordan, Suzanne, Wikitoria Romana. Shelby Jean Rose. Alexandra Ann Wally Rosser. Waikareka Emily Rufu Toms. Justine Rosemary Sachs. Alia Saib. Maria Coretti Sang Yum. Christina Meleane Sautia. Thames and Victoria Copeland Savage. Wren Alexander Sayer. Michelle Rose Mary Scott. Sally Seto. Natasha Shamila Sharan. Kathleen Shabon Sheehan. Maureen Francis Chauve. Megan Catherine Chauve. Sasha Shu. Chetan Anirudra Singh. Roman Priet Singh. Jeremy William Kingston Smith. Sonia Rose Stephen. Kelly Alexandra Stewart. Mark Carter Stokes. Danielle Cherie Stone. Coral Francesca Stroud. Henry James Swanson. Lutza Sabo. Piliami Tuli Ki Takao. Chunming Tan. Jesse Jia Xin Tang. Ziki Tang. Wen Chi Tao. Rebecca Lisa Teska. Lakena Joyce Tao Lili. Patricia Taulapapa. Jamie Teata Ture Fenua Simon Tafiao. Jeremy Stephen Julian Teal. Venita Monique Thorna. Nicola Ann Lily Tickner. Julia Louise Sectalin Tolentino. Ian Angela Tu. Mele Seini, Tukia. Charlotte Sonia Turner. Kitsia Michaela Janice Tyler. Miriam Futapu Uele. Charlotte Dora Underhill Hewison. Brandon Wolf Teariki Utia. Agnes Toe Umo Fakolaifanga Vaya. Jonathan Elliott Bain Walters. Young Wang. Linda Joy Angela Warren. Courtney Bronwyn Watt. Dominique Xavier Weber. Wei Wei. Catherine Elizabeth Westlake. Marie Wickman. Karen William. Sarah Elizabeth Williams. Stephanie Christine Wilson. Chloe Evelyn Wintour. Vinuli Witanaracie. Jamie Tsi Yen Wong. Rachel Margaret Woods. Lin Jun Yen. Sunny Tun Jing Yang. Xuan In. Zhang Tao Yu. Sarah Yung. Xi Yi Jiang. Yuan Zhou. To the degree of Bachelor of Theology, Shandalina Ida Toala. The degree of Bachelor of Arts Conjoint, Grace Ellen Abbott, and a Bachelor of Law Honours. Oscar Thomas Cornfield, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Beatriz Amor Onquico de la Cruz, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Catherine Franklin, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Petra Caterina Jaspers Bedford, and a Bachelor of Commerce. Harry John Clare and a Bachelor of Commerce. Abigail Ellen Leach and a Bachelor of Commerce. Samuel Martin Lynch and a Bachelor of Commerce. Connor Patrick McCabe and a Bachelor of Commerce. Senuri Yuwanika Panditaratine and a Bachelor of Science. To the degree of Bachelor of Theology, conjoint. Cruz Pomere Teoranga Karati Fox. Postgraduate Diploma in Arts with Merit. Mwimwi Heloto Akaola in Education. Rebecca Mary McKenzie in Psychology. Veronica Rabova in Psychology. Yuming Jai in Psychology. Postgraduate Diploma in Arts. Natasha Miriam Bonia in Education. Lily Wang in Media, Film and Television. Wunfang Zhou in Media, Film and Television. Postgraduate Diploma in Translation Studies with Distinction, Jing Guo. Postgraduate Diploma in Translation Studies, So Yung Kim. Chen Zhang. To the degree of Bachelor of Arts Honours with First Class Honours, Julia Ann Craig in Art History and a Bachelor of Arts. Courtney Michelle Grundy in Politics and International Relations. Benjamin Michael Hall in Media, Film and Television. Lydia Claire Hollister-Jones in Development Studies and a Bachelor of Arts. T. Lamous in Sociology and a Bachelor of Arts. Niles Alexander Makauskas in Sociology. Katie Helena Margaret Rickson in Drama. Elizabeth Helen Thomas in Anthropology. David Allen Junrung Ting in Sociology. Liliana Sera Duionedoa in Psychology. Sarah Jane White in Museums and Cultural Heritage. Wei Yi Zhang in Politics and International Relations. To the degree of Bachelor of Arts Honours with Second Class Honours First Division, April Charlotte Jane Clayson in Anthropology.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Samson Setu on vocal, accompanied by Claire Corbell on piano, will now play V Reviso by Vincenzo Bellini.
Il fonte, il bosco, e vicin la fattoria. Vi ravviso, o luoghi ameni, in cui lieti, in cui sereni. Tranquillo in i passai della prima gioventù, cari luoghi. Passai della prima gioventù, cari luoghi, io vi trovai, cari luoghi, io vi trovai, ma querim non trovo più. Non trovo più, non trovo, non trovo.
Thank you, Samson and Claire, for that delightful performance. Will you all join with me in thanking Samson and Claire once again? By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Arts and the Faculty of Education and Social Work, have satisfied the requirements of this university. I call upon the co-head of school, Te Wānanga o Waipapa, and the Faculty of Arts, Associate Professor Damon Salisi, to present further graduands and the faculty.
To the degree of Bachelor of Arts Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division, Timothy James Harrison in English. Amar Kumar Jaku in Politics and International Relations. Laura Elizabeth Lovegrove in Politics and International Relations and a Bachelor of Arts. Matthew Logan McLennan in Philosophy. Susanna Rose Middleton Oliver in Music and a Bachelor of Arts. Rianne Alice Muir in French. Charlotte Fleur Robinson in Drama. Sasha Rosalie Supin in Politics and International Relations. Apenti Ewera Tamanui Franson in Māori Studies. To the degree of Bachelor of Arts Honours with a Second Class Honours Second Division, Hui Ching Ao in Sociology. Jay Tafuatai Masina in Anthropology. To the degree of Master of Arts with First Class Honours, Carl Stewart Adams in Development Studies. Lydia Marguerite Bashford in Ancient History. Karishma Joyce Beach in Psychology. Sebastian Montgomery Christian Bennett in Ancient History. Andrew Ross Blackman in Screen Production. Eleanor Margaret Bloomfield in English. Connolly Joy Bourne in Psychology. James Bruce Cassidy in Ancient History. Anna Christine Chilcott in Ancient History. Marie Donnell Clegg in Art History. Seth Alexander Davies in Ancient History. Holly Claire Dixon in Psychology. Jamie Marie Dudley in Anthropology. University Graduate Scholar, Katrina Jane Edwards in Ancient History. Faculty Graduate Scholar, Elizabeth Andrea Eltz in Ancient History. Faculty Graduate Scholar, Anna Louise Gilderdale in History. Faculty Graduate Scholar, Rihanna Hartman in Sociology. Mana Tawipu Laumea in Anthropology. Michael Cannon Miller in Screen Production. Bevan Ken Morgan in History. Clara Jeanette Morrell in Political Studies, and a Bachelor of Arts Honours with First Class Honours in Political Studies, and a Bachelor of Arts. J.
Jaesung Park and Ancient History. Cameron Tyler Pitney in Screen Production. Jane Elizabeth Ruck in Art History. Caitlin Bonham Smith in Anthropology. Rebecca Jane Ward in Art History. Oscar James West in Drama. Charlotte Kate Victoria Worsfold in English. Jingwen Wu in Applied Linguistics. To the degree of Master of Arts with Second Class Honours, First Division. Sukriti Bhatnagar in Education. Radley Joshua Eric Fenner in Screen Production. Ripdamun Jeet Kaur in Education. Benjamin Alexander O'Callaghan in History and a postgraduate diploma in Arts with distinction in History. To the degree of Master of Arts with Second Class Honours, Second Division. Francois René Dutoy in History. Ian Alexander Russell in History. To the degree of Master of Arts, Midua Guo in Philosophy. Jun Pyo Hung in Education. To the degree of Master of Creative Writing with First Class Honours, Tulia Thompson. To the degree of Master of Creative Writing with Second Class Honours, First Division, Cecilia Etewati. To the degree of Master of Creative Writing with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Juliet Joan Robeson. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies with First Class Honours, Gloria Juliana Bustamante Reyes in International Relations and Human Rights. To the degree of Master of Public Policy with First Class Honours, Gay Marie Manolo Francisco. Velicia Naidu. Marianne Michelle Wardlow. To the degree of Master of Public Policy with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Travis Michael Gary McDonald. To the degree of Master of Teaching English to Speakers of Other Languages with First Class Honours, Rochelle Marie Hewen. To the degree of Master of Teaching English to Speakers of Other Languages with Second Class Honours, First Division, Hua Fan. To the degree of Master of Teaching English to Speakers of Other Languages with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Zhang Yaowun. To the degree of Master of Literature with Second Class Honours, First Division, Kim Marie in Screen Production and a Postgraduate Diploma in Arts with distinction in Film, Television and Media Studies. In absentia, all those other persons named in the official record qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Arts.
Mm-hmm.
I now call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Education and Social Work, Professor Graham Aitken, to present graduands in the faculty.
Chancellor, as Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Education and Social Work. Graduate Diploma in Teaching, Early Childhood Education, Margaret Ann Dennehy. Baktava Sami Chitkar. Graduate Diploma in Teaching Primary, Farisha Begum. Glenn Michael Burgess. Nilesh Desai. Kerry Raymond Harding. Diane Ritzi Pacheco Rojas. Jennifer Rose Williams. Graduate Diploma in Teaching Secondary, Albert Alexander Omaho Belt. Rory Samuel Lawrence Carroll Mayer. Catherine Elizabeth Francis Hamilton. Shannon May Reed. Graduate Diploma in Teaching English in Schools to Speakers of Other Languages, Nicola Lee Kingston. Matauta Leota. Kirsten Jane McLaren. Vandana Salwan. Anthea Joy Stein. To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching. Nasim Ali. Barbara Juliet Ash Farlalu. Edward Philip John Beale. Akisa Nai Beratambo. Charlotte Paige Boaza. Rebecca Mary Burgess. Georgia Ann Burt. Savannah Ruth Cuisinas Casey. Stephanie Adele Clayton. Miranda Jane Cooper. Christina Lee Davis. Bree Annie Evans. Benita Falisifulu Fa'olo. Alice Karen Fenton. Luciani Fafita. Okay. Joy Chantal Fisher. Amy Jacinta Godinet. Vivek Gopal. Rochelle Elizabeth Hawkswood. Yenna Hill. Liam Jade Jansen. Simrandeep Kaur. Poco Kirkwood. Lisa Veronica Kamor. Hannah Louise Lorenz. Falakehe Mapapalangi. Eric Pineu. Natasha Ann Pierce. Amelia Pojajo. Chelsea May Rona. Sosafina Velda Seve. Ariel Janice Stella Sulunga. Laura Elizabeth Seal. Karen Anil Solanki. Oliver James Staub. Byron Cornelius Stevenson. Imbra Nathan Subramani. Mangafa Fitifiti Lofili Tengafua. Maripa Tuala. Elena Kylie Walker. Kayla Ann Woolwork. Megan Eve Marie Walters. Michael Robert Wells. To the degree of Bachelor of Human Services, Carolyn Ellis Chambers. Florence Iovale. Laura Ann Olson. To the degree of Bachelor of Physical Education, Ellen Marie Henderson. Dennis George Patello. To the degree of Bachelor of Social Work, Emily Hope Catherine Henderson. Tracy Catherine MacDonald. Delilah Mosca. Joseph Tavita Wright. Postgraduate Diploma in Counselling Theory with Merit. Matthew Alexander Flynn. Postgraduate Diploma in Education with Distinction. Lynn Christine Gardner. Heidi Vincent Leah. Lisa Joanne Scrivens. Postgraduate Diploma in Education with Merit. Ivy Darlene Cameron. Anita Tresiana Dewey. Postgraduate Diploma in Education, Dong Li Chao. Postgraduate Diploma in Educational Leadership with Merit, Vibol Boy. Cheryl Angela Fletcher. Dara Kim. Tharith Survey. Postgraduate Diploma in Professional Supervision, Ofa Manu. To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching Honours with First Class Honours, University Graduate Scholar, Sarah Louise Jones. To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division, Troy Shane Lund. To the degree of Master of Counselling with First Class Honours, Ya Shin Lai. Anna Jane Kirsten McWilliams. To the degree of Master of Counselling with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Isabel Marion Dillon. Valerie Joyce McCulloch. To the degree of Master of Counselling with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Shi Yi Tang. To the degree of Master of Education with First Class Honours, Anna Maria Brebeskia. Carolyn Rose Crow. Catherine Teresa Eltringham. David Hithersay. Andrew Michael Majka. Myelaine White Van Diesen. Sinead Colleen Wilson. To the degree of Master of Education with Second Class Honours, First Division, Renu Lata Naidu. Sweetie Vidal Naik. Kerry Margaret Priest. Kelly Joanna Frances Slater Brown. Chu Yao. To the degree of Master of Educational Leadership with Second Class Honours, First Division, Gina Marie Hemmingson. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies with First Class Honours, Barbara Margaret Ngawati in Education. Adrian Rachel Wood in Education. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies with Second Class Honours, First Division, Amanda Jane Corbell in Education. Julie Lorraine Marshall in Education. Nathan Peniamina Samu in Education. Luisa Helena Tuitopo in Education. Deborah Ann Ward in Education. Rebecca Denise Wharton in Education. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies with Second Class Honours, Second Division, William Anthony Trevor Hadnett in Education. Jane Walters in Education. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies, Lei Filimaua in Education. Christine Lataisi Atupo in Education. To the degree of Master of Social Work with First Class Honours, Sarah Eleanor Elliott. Shelley Kirk and a postgraduate diploma in social work with distinction. Natasha Urale Baker. To the degree of Master of Social Work with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Jolene Evelyn Cartwright. To the degree of Master of Social Work Professional with Second Class Honours, First Division, Antonia Margaret Britt. To the degree of Master of Social Work Professional, Sione Fungale Maka. To the degree of Master of Teaching Primary with First Class Honours, Shakira Holly Atkins. Betsy May Flynn. Yan Yuo Lin. Lucy Eleanor Lindfield. Morgan Ann Lupton. Stephanie Jane Martin. Kapua Fergus Alexis O'Connor. Geraldine Erin Reed Pinau. Chloe Kosa Stanage. Karis Wing He Tang. Sarah May Taylor. Caitlin O'Brien Thompson. Tessa Jane Van Zulen. Emma Christine White. To the degree of Master of Teaching Primary with Second Class Honours First Division, Dawn Becky Anderson. Brittany Kate Buchanan. Fraser Luke Cocaine Gooden. Teresa Marie Coyle. Alexander Charles Douglas Haynes. Esther Lee. Grace Mariner Duncan. Maren Ruth McLeod. Hayley Ellen Paul. Eric Graham Shadbolt. To the degree of Master of Teaching Primary with Second Class Honours Second Division, Annika Julia Emily Browers. Kate Margaret Chatterley. Emily Victoria Grace Cooper. Olivia Christy Manson. Nicola Jane Russell. To the degree of Master of Teaching Secondary with First Class Honours, Kimberly Michelle Cook. Charlotte Emily Forster. Renee Catherine Gordon. Sarah Ellen Hughes. To the degree of Master of Teaching Secondary with Second Class Honours First Division, Brianna Ray Baker. Alf Christopher Eckholm. Rebecca Claire George. Tanya Marie Hartnell. Basant Ibrahim. Kayla Tremaine Manasia. Christine Rachel Newvote. To the degree of Master of Teaching Secondary with Second Class Honours Second Division, Vanessa Marie Dowd. Elizabeth Mary Hyde Hills. Sylvia Manu Mehunga Tafuna Liava'a.
I now call upon the Deputy Vice-Chancellor Academic, Professor John Morrow, to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduates. To the degree of Doctor of Education, Judine Brenda Ladbrook. Exploring 10 years digital and page leisure reading choices, Judine found a complex interplay of factors that limited exploitation of the opportunities these choices offer for literacy development in school. Recommendations include valuing and accommodating students' choices to increase reading motivation, broadening the traditional definition of text, increasing the range of text studied, and strengthening critical digital information literacy. Judine. Anne Stokes O'Callaghan. Anne explored why doctors do not always communicate effectively. She developed a grounded theory that explains how doctors can engage, use, lose, or misuse their voice depending on the relational landscape and the specific hierarchy within any given team. This research has significant implications for reducing suffering and complaints related to communication, as well as improving clinical outcomes for patients and reducing burnout in doctors. Anne. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, University Doctoral Scholar Kathleen Araha Brett Kelly Chalmers in Art History. Kathleen's research examined the philosophy of time in contemporary art practices from the 1960s to the present. She studied a diverse range of artworks that have shaped the way we experience time as a system of measurement, a feature of human perception, and a process of ecological change. Kathleen. Susan Margaret Crabtree in Development Studies. Susan used concepts from complexity thinking to reveal barriers to the successful implementation of recommended international maternal health strategies, taking East New Britain, Papua New Guinea, as a case study. She argues that development agencies must work with unique local systems to develop effective solutions to improve outcomes for women and babies at birth. Susan. University Doctoral Scholar Benjamin Andrew Davies in Anthropology. Ben examined how the archaeological record forms in Australia's arid zone using computational models to explore complex interactions of sedimentary and behavioural processes in desert landscapes. With large data sets of stone tool measurements and radiocarbon dates for comparison, Ben showed how these processes can transform the record over time, challenging popular theories about demographic changes during the last 2,000 years. Yan Ding in Translation Studies. In a controlled interpreting experiment, Yan used a mixture of analytical tools to examine both the interpreting quality and the interpreting strategy. Yan found that domain knowledge affects information processing at the sentence and discourse level, and that domain knowledge improves the reproduction rates of particular types of propositions. Congratulations. Yeah. John Peter Fox in English. John examined the biblical language of building and reforming in the context of Protestant poetry of the Reformation. He argued that building language is an imaginative key to the reform of the English Church and to the poetry of Spenser, Herbert, Sidney, and Donne. Deborah Kathleen Green in Education. Deborah used art making and creative writing to explore her personal and professional experiences as arts therapist during the Canterbury earthquakes and their aftermath. She articulated several ideas that may be useful to other psychotherapists and art-based practitioners working with post-traumatic stress, trauma, and natural disaster. Marie Kim in Asian Studies. Marie proposed and elaborated a new subgenre in adolescent fiction in Japan, which portrays teenage delinquency and rebellion. Her thesis opens up a new strand of critical discourse on Japanese rebellious youth culture, specifically in fiction, which complements and enhances the existing focus on anime and film. She also maps the parallels and divergences in the development of rebellious youth culture in the United States and Japan. Yong Lu in Media, Film and Television. Against the backdrop of the stereoscopic 3D cinema's current resurgence and its integration of digital technologies, Yong analyzed the narrative tropes and techniques explored by contemporary 3D filmmakers, arguing that the contemporary 3D films have become more sophisticated in their use of stereoscopic effects for narrative purposes rather than simply generating spectacle. The case studies Yong discusses in his thesis include popular 3D films such as Gravity, Life of Pi, The Great Gatsby, and The Hobbit Trilogy. Mandisi Majavu in Sociology. Mandisi undertook the first academic study to investigate and compare the experiences of Black African refugees who reside in Australia and New Zealand. The thesis disrupted the hegemonic mode of researching and theorizing Black Africans by drawing on innovative race analysis that allowed the development of a new theoretical concept to better interrogate the life struggles of the study's participants. Congratulations. University doctoral scholar PE2E Lia Nikula in Politics and International Relations. PE2E Lia examined the tertiary education student funding policies in regard to student-state cost-sharing in Finland and New Zealand between 1989 and 2013. Her research advances our understanding of the causes, explaining the stability and change in the generosity of these programs. University doctoral scholar Gerard O'Regan in Anthropology. Comparing South Canterbury and Western Taupo, Gerard questioned whether traditional Maori ideas about places can be demonstrated through archaeological methods. He showed that while it is possible in a few cases, more typically this is prevented by poor preservation of the archaeological deposits, rock art and the surrounding landscape features. The results invite a rethinking of how we assess Maori heritage places. Right. Sabina Riemann in English. In her research, Sabina has looked at the various meanings of walls in fictional and non-fictional narratives of Lahore. Her research showed that walls stand as social cultural structures at spatial, linguistic, and gender-specific levels, and examined how various writers in English have represented these as both dividing and connecting factors. James Rogers in Sociology. James studies visitors to three prison museums, the Eastern State Penitentiary in the USA, Robben Island in South Africa, and Fremantle Jail in Western Australia. He asked whether the museums were intended to entertain or educate, and concluded that visiting prison museums does not appear to have the humanising effect many people might have hoped it would have. James. University doctoral scholar Rachel Manu Scott in anthropology. Rachel investigated the diet and health of ancient Egyptians by looking at the wear patterns of their teeth and changes to their skeletons. She concentrated on periods of political upheaval and climatic change. Rachel found that the healthiest Egyptians lived when the ancient pharaohs first began to reign over the country. Judith Ann Selvaraj. Judith looked at the possibilities and limitations of current New Zealand education policy in its relationship to secondary and pre-service teacher education. She critiqued inclusion in education and special education policies, practices and processes since 1989, and their implementation within a neoliberal policy environment. Zakwa Shaheen in media, film and television. Zakwa analysed the perception of literate and semi-literate Pakistani women regarding climate hazards in relation to their own media use and context. The study provided insights into women's knowledge and understanding about climate change and natural hazards while reflecting on how media in developing nations can manage the gender-specific effects of climate change and assist in disaster risk reduction. University doctoral scholar Li Teng in education. Li Teng reconciled contemporary paradigms of both social, cultural and social cognitive theories to investigate how the instruction of self-regulated learning strategies contributed to second language learners' writing proficiency. This mixed methods research offered insightful evidence for implementing effective writing instruction with an aim of developing strategic learners. Susan Ann Thorpe in ancient history. Susan studied and analysed the wide selection of private letters from the various periods of ancient Egyptian history. This showed how such personal correspondence is an important primary source of social history in ancient Egypt, giving insight into the issues of daily life, religious belief, and military custom. Catherine Mary Twyford in education. Teachers' reluctance to engage in educational change is commonly labelled as resistance. Kay's research showed that most teachers are willing to engage, but feel vulnerable because of the perceived risk when doing so. The perceived risk related to the increased uncertainty surrounding their professional learning experiences. Viewing non-engagement in change as risk rather than resistance provides a more positive perspective for leaders to use when supporting their teachers during professional learning. University doctoral scholar Matthew Adam Wynyard in sociology. Matthew examined the social and environmental costs and consequences associated with the growth and development of the New Zealand dairy industry, including the systematic dispossession of Maori land in the 19th century, the dispossession of Nauruan phosphates throughout the 20th century, and the increasingly widespread and serious degradation of New Zealand's freshwater commons more recently. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a doctoral degree in the Faculty of Arts and the Faculty of Education and Social Work.
We are nearing the end of this graduation ceremony. On behalf of the university, I invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. While you are standing, this will be a great time for you to show your appreciation to your families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped you as you achieved your qualifications. Thank you. This concludes this meeting of Council and convocation of the University for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you all to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori, then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of the programme.